Thank you very much. You, well, the audience is fantastic. Saturday morning in Madrid, the normal is not too much people in the meeting or Congress, but thank you very much you stay here. I describe this technique. It's a beaver technique, but beaver is another two significations, and I prefer to put it. Dim beaver technique. Why this technique? It's because it's very easy, and of course it's very easy to learn the novel neurointerventional radiologist. When you treat the ABM, you are every time free your embol going to the venous part. But you are the control flow before in the pedicle, you stop the flow, and you is possible to injection the onyx or glue slowly. You know, you don't have free going too much material in the venous side. This technique is have a difference with the pressure cook described by René Chapeau, because this is the most easy. Only use a double microcatheter. One catheter is to use the Onyx, and I prefer to use the Apollo 3 or 5 centimeters, it's depending when you want to stop the clot before the nidus. And the second coil is to use one macrocatheter, a standard macrocatheter, to use the coils. I prefer to use the fiber coils, but sometimes I use a standard coil or another technique. This is the difference of the pressure cook. You are the pressure cook. The problem is when you use the magic catheter, sometimes the catheter move, you need to put more coils, 1, 2, 3, 5 coils. The liquid coils is very soft coils, and sometimes have migration to the venous side. And the good technique of the beaver technique is possible you have the test occlusion in the feeder. What is this? When you need to know where is the collateral circulation of the arterial or the venous, you need to test in, and you put this coil, you stop the flow, and then you have a new angio, and you have the possibility to analyze better the anatomical angio architecture of the AVM. The difference with the septal balloon, the problem is when you inflate the balloon in one pedicle, half AVM, you have a risk of rupture of the vessel. It's low risk, but you have a risk. And when you deflate when you inject the onyx or glue to stop the flow, and you are sometimes the glue onyx is stuck with the balloon. And when you remove, it's possible the migration. This is the reason why I prefer to use the standard catheter, whatever you want, to the standard coils. It's possible to use the onyx or squid or another off field. For me, I don't have high difference. Only you are the difference to the opacity of the nidus, but technical, I think it's not have many big difference with onyx, squid, or field. I think the difference is only when you push the material and you know where it's going the embol. I think it's better because you are less opacification of the cast of the nidus. And the squid, you are one squid is possible to migrate more distal, But this change is possible to use with the standard Onyx, where you push more high or more or less high, or you control the flow. Now in this hospital, I treated every AVM with arterial and venous approach in the same time. Why? Because I learned with Professor Udak, I think is the venous approach. You start with the catheter in arterial and venous, and then you utilize whatever you want, the arterial or venous approach. But the venous approach sometimes is very good to complete or to continue to embolization. This is an AVM. Before treatment, I analyze every time the collateral circulation. The AVM is a lenticular striate Sylvian LVM, big AVM. This is the collateral circulation of leptomeningeal anastomosis, and this is the middle cerebral artery. This is the flow in the nidus, and this is the collateral circulation of the posterior communicant artery. Why I need to study this part? Because it's possible to close every part of the middle cerebral artery because you are a standard anastomosis, a standard circular collateral circulation with evolution of the AVM. This is the AVM. You are a bigger ectasia, venous ectasia, a bigger cortical drainage. No deep drainage, very slow deep drainage, and the feeders come of the middle cerebral artery and come of the choroidal artery. This is the choroidal part, and this is the lenticulostriate ascending part. In a lateral view, you have three big feeders of the middle cerebral artery, but the nidus is in the deep part of Sylvian fissure, and you are the dilatation of the vein is significant because you are three direct fistula. No, you are nidus and fistula, and this is the anterior choroidal artery. And this is the point, plexus point, described before by Matsumoto. You are a little ectasia or aneurysm. Where is the point? Here. Okay. It's very, in this slice, it's difficult to analyze where is the real component or compartment of the nidus. But when you use the Beaver technique, it's possible to inject the Onyx in this part with coil in the feeder before, and then you add the analyze of this part of this compartment of this vein. This is another pedicle in the posterior branch of the middle cerebral artery, going in deep part of the lenticulostriate territory. You are the vein, and here is the cast where you see the coil. You see the coil here, and you see the coil here, and it's possible with this method to analyze very, very most comfortable the what happened in the nidus, what happened in the malformation. After the disembolization, this is the initial embolization. The third embolization, after three sessions, I close totally part of the lenticulostriate artery, but still open the choroidal point. And the patient in this size, I decide to send the patient to gamma knife or radio surgery, but the problem is the patient wait 2 or 3 months and come. And okay, this is a foreign embolization. Okay, no problem. I come 3 months later and bleeding because the rest of the nidus is the deep portion. And this is one point is for me it's very difficult to understand. When the bleed in the AVM, in this part of the AVM, I think why bleeding the deep part, I think is because I close the cort, the external part, and the deep part, normal, when you are the lenticular artery or carotid artery, you are every time the intra-aneurysmal in the feeder. You are, it's possible, similar, the same of a Charcot aneurysm, it's possible this is the reason of the bleeding. This is the angio after the bleeding. And you see that it's not too much rest of the AVM, but I need to treat it, this part. And it's difficult because you are one aneurysm here, ectasia in the infundibular, the choroidal artery, and this point. I prefer to use, Matsumoto, I prefer to use the macro catheter magic, not the marathon, because the magic is very soft, is more easy to navigate without micro grid wire. And every time I use the glue. And this is the AP view, this is the lateral view. This branch is not the branch going to the corona radiata, is a branch going in the deep part of the choroidal part. No, it's not the branch going to the corona radiata is here in the plexus point. This branch is here. After embolization with glue, you are APVU with the glue, and you are here, the glue, to total occlude this segment. The patient is stay away, but 1 month later, in period of time extend to radiocele, rebleeding and death. I think is maybe, I don't know why, probably rest another feeder of the lenticular territory with aneurysm. This is another patient, another technique with the dim waiver technique. When I use the coil, onyx, magic, you are here one high flow fistula in parietal posterior region in the right side. This is the direct fistula. And before the technique of Beaver, I inject every time the glue in this segment. Now with the Beaver, you put here some coils or some stop glue or whatever you want, and then distal part, the catheter. This is the catheter in distal part and the catheter in the proximal part. It's possible to put the coil and then use, in this case, I use the onyx. No, use the glue. After first embolization, the patient have headaches and 1 week later, and this is due to change, hemodynamic change in the brain. It is the breakthrough. It's due when you close a very high flow fistula, you need, sometimes you are the risk or you change the flow and you are the modification of the regulation of the vessel, but the patient stay well and the control 2 weeks later is thrombosis progressive of the AVM and finally is totally closed this AVM. Another example, I use the glue brand, but I don't use the coils. Why is this? What is this? It's possible when you put in the catheter, you SL10 or Echelon, where you want, it's possible to put the coil, or why not? I start with the, inject the onyx in the Apollo, in the distal part of the nidus, I have the reflux, and when I the reflux in the pedicle, I use the onyx, the glue, and have the stop the flow, and the glue don't let it go in the onyx more in the pedicle. anytime advance to the neighbor. This is one EVM, parietal posterior, and this is collateral circulation of the leptomeningeal iliar part, and this is feeder of the middle cerebral artery. You are here 3D reconstruction, and this you are the cast of onyx. This is a road map in 3D. The image is very good, and sometimes I use this technique because it's possible to rotate the image and to know where is part the nidus is close, or where do you want to go with the onyx. I think it is very it's possible. It's very help to 3D the AVM. This is the injection selective, and this is the cast of onyx. In AP view, and finally, it's totally close this AVM. I don't have this cotton, but it's totally cured this AVM. This is another example. Another AVM is treated before with onyx in this part, but this pedicle, I need to stop the flow here and go in this part of nidus. You put here the coil, and then you put the microcatheteris here. This is the injection. And in this part, I use the coil and inject some bubbles of glue. And when I inject the onyx, I know the onyx don't go in this part, only advance in the nidus. This is the after embolization FP view, in lateral view, and you know you are very good the cast of onyx, and you don't have migration of the vein, and this is with my partner colleagues in the hospital, and still embolization without risk, and I think it's very comfortable and very interesting to learn the Jung or the Nobel neurointerventional. Conclusion: onyx or glue for me, I don't have main. Onyx or glue are too much difference, but it's mandatory to know the onyx and glue. No, it's stop glue. No. The glue is very important to know. And the onyx or fill or is important. It's very interesting before you embolize every AVM to know the collateral circulation of the parenchymal, of the brain, of the malformation. External carotid artery is a good part to treat it. And the venous and arterial approach is the second topic. I think is the same philosophy or the same experience of the Professor Udak. Thank you for your attention.